Good morning students. Now we'll go for the next topic, your face detector. So we'll see the individual components of your face lock loop. Under that, the first topic we are going to see is your face detector. So basically we know that your face detector is going to compare the input frequency and the VCO frequency there. So by comparing your VCO frequency and input frequency, it is going to generate a DC voltage which is going to be proportional to the phase difference between the two frequencies there. So here we can categorize, we can classify a phase detector as an analog or digital phase detector there. So based on that, we can say that it can be defined as an analog type phase detector or a digital type phase detector. So here your monolithic PLL integrated circuits, it is going to use your analog phase detectors there. So the majority of the phase detectors which you are going to use is going to be of digital type. Why we are going to go for digital type is because of its simplicity. So if you want to see your analog phase detector, it is going to be basically a switch. So here we are interested only with your digital type. So we will go for a digital type phase detectors. Examples of digital phase detectors are going to be your exclusive OR phase detector, edge triggered phase detector, monolithic phase detector there. So the example for analog phase detector where we are going to use your analog phase detector is in your double balanced mixer applications, you'll be using your analog phase detector. Digital phase detectors where we are nothing but your exclusive OR phase detectors or edge triggered phase detectors or monolithic phase detectors there. So first we'll see about your exclusive OR phase detector there. So the name itself tells exclusive OR means you are going to use basically an exclusive OR gate to realize your phase detector there. So we know that the output of the phase detector is going to be high only when F in or your F out is high. When any one of the input is going to be high, only one input should be high. So any one input is going to be high, then the output of the exclusive OR gate is going to be high. That is, the input should be different, and in that, if any one input is going to be high, you are going to have the output to be high. If the inputs are going to be same, you are going to have the output to be zero there. So the DC output voltage of the exclusive OR phase detector is going to be a function of the phase difference between the two outputs. So now we'll see your exclusive OR phase detector. So here your inputs to your phase detectors are going to be F in and F out, and output is going to be your VDC voltage there. So to your F in, I'm going to give a square waveform, and to your F out, again that is also nothing but a square waveform, but which is going to be phase shifted by phi there. So here these two signals we are going to give it to your exclusive OR phase detector there. So we can see that at this time period T1, you can see that your input is going to be, F in is going to be high, but F naught is going to be low. So here high low means your output of the phase detector is going to be high. So I'm going to have a high output. At time T2, at this instant, if I'm going to see, your F in is also going to be high, F out is also going to be high. When both inputs are going to be high, my output is going to be low. When inputs are same, my outputs of exclusive OR gate is going to be zero. So my output is going to be zero. So at time period T3, if I'm going to see, here my F in is going to be zero, but my F out is going to be high. So when both are going to be different, my output is going to be high. So you can see that in this time period, I'm going to have the phase difference, that is the pulse, DC pulse output is going to be generated for every pi duration there. So here the phase shift between these two signals are going to be phi. So we can see that we are going to have the average output voltage to be versus your phase difference. If you are going to plot for a phi phase difference, we are going to have the radiation is going to be a straight one, and it is going to achieve VCC is equivalent to approximately, the output voltage is going to be approximately V saturation when the phase difference between the input signal and the oscillator signal is going to be pi. And again from pi to 2 pi, if I'm going to see, you are going to get the next phase difference. So in that case it comes to zero. So we say that your average output voltage versus your phase difference between your F in and F out. So here between 0 to pi, your signal rises and it is going to have a slope conversion gain Kp. And from pi to 2 pi, the slope decreases there. So here we are going to have for the negative cycle, so we say that the slope decreases there. This is the operation of your exclusive OR gate. So next is, we can see that the maximum DC output voltage is going to occur when the phase difference is going to be pi radians or 180 degrees. So the slope of the curve, that is between 0 or pi radians, is the conversion gain Kp of the phase detector. So if the exclusive OR gate is going to use a supply voltage of VCC, that is 5 volts, the conversion gain Kp is going to be given as 5 divided by pi, that is 1.59 volts per radians. So next is, we are going to go for edge triggered phase detector. So edge triggered type phase detector is nothing but basically an RS flip flop there. So here your RS flip flop is going to be constructed using your cross couple NOR gates there. So it is going to be formed from a pair of cross couple NOR gates. So if the RS flip flop is going to be triggered, the output of the detector is going to change its logic state on the positive edges of the F in and F out. So here we can see that this is your edge triggered flip flop. Here F in is going to be given to the S input, F now out is going to be given to the R input there. So we know that your SR flip flop truth table is going to be, when both the inputs are going to be 0, 0, it is going to occupy the previous state. When it is going to be S is 0 means my Q is going to be 0, that means my output is 0. When S is 1 means my Q is going to be 1. So when both the inputs are going to be 1, it is the forbidden state there. So this is the truth table of your RS flip flop. With that truth table, you are going to see now how we are out, this circuit is going to work. So my F in is going to be here high at this particular T1 time, but my F out is going to be low. That means my S is going to be 1 and R is going to be 0. S is 1 means the output is going to be 1 there. And next is, here at this time period, if I am going to see, my S is 0, R is 0. When both the inputs are going to be 0, it is going to follow the previous state. So my previous state was 1, so it is going to follow the previous state. So at this time period T2, I am going to see means my R is going to be 1, but S is going to be 0. When S is going to be 0, my output is going to be 0. So my output comes to 0 here. And here at this time period, if I am going to see, your both S as well as R are going to be 0. When both S and R are going to be 0, my output is going to be 0 there. Now at this time period, if I am going to see, here my S is going to be 1, R is going to be 0. That means my waveform is going to be repeated there. So here my waveform repeats for every pi radians there. So we can see that we are going to have a linear slope for pi radians there. So here in this case, for 2 pi radians, we are going to have a linear slope. And we are going to have the maximum saturation to occur at 2 pi radians there. So we say that the DC output voltage is going to be linear over 2 pi radians or 360 degrees. But in exclusive OR, it is your pi radians or 180 degrees there. So in this case, we say that the advantage of this edge triggered is it can have better capture range because the DC output voltage is going to be linear over 2 pi radians. So because of that, we can say that your edge triggered phase detector is going to have better capture, tracking as well as the locking characteristics there. So here your monolithic phase detector, basically it is going to consist of two digital phase detectors there and a charge pump and an amplifier there. So the function of the phase detector 1 is going to be used in applications which is going to require zero frequency and phase difference at lock there. And phase detector 2 is going to be used if quadrature lock is going to be designed. That is, when detector 1 is going to be used in the main loop, and the detector kit can also be used to indicate whether the main loop is in lock or out of lock. So for that, these are the different symbols you are going to use. One is, R is going to be used for reference, V is going to be a variable or feedback input, PU is nothing but the pump up signal, PD refers to pump down signals, UF is your up frequency output signal, DF is your down frequency output signal. So here this is your internal block diagram there. So it consists of two phase frequency detectors, a charge pump and an amplifier there. So here to this phase detector, we are going to give the two inputs, your R and V, your reference, and your V is nothing but your variable or your feedback input. That is nothing but the input from your phase detector, that is your VCO there. So these are the inputs and these are going to be the outputs there. So here you are going to have your PD, as I said, your PD is nothing but your pump down signal. So here these are the different signals which you are going to have, and the slope is going to be linear over a range of 2 pi radians. So this is the graph of your output voltage versus your phase difference. Thank you.